Brothers and sisters, let's just pray real fast. Holy Spirit, Lord, this is your show. I know that many brothers and sisters have repented of abortion or causing a female to get an abortion. So, Lord, we know that Moloch is prevalent in our day and age, especially in America, especially in other nations. So, Father God, please, we know that you go before us. We give this time to you. Please speak to us. Please pierce any confusion, doubt, and unbelief. Please pierce that, Lord. Please pierce the demonic. Get to the truth and cast out these demons. Amen. Amen. So I was in church during worship, and the Holy Spirit dropped in my spirit, you need to do a video casting out Moloch. Now, I've tried to record this already, and it's kind of difficult because normally, you know, when I'm working with a client, I'm able to get instant feedback. Even the way they act, their facial expressions, you know, how they even hear, you know, if they hear yes, no, no, yes, you know, that's usually a sign of confusion. So I usually get instant feedback. So this is a little difficult for me, but I believe that God can use it still because he told me to do it. So who needs to watch this video? Well, one, if you've had an abortion, okay. Two, if you've caused a woman to get an abortion, or three, if you are like a person of authority or a friend maybe who looked the other direction and didn't try to stop somebody from getting an abortion, okay? Somebody in your sphere of influence, because that also is a curse as well. Now, there's a fourth reason. In my deliverance sessions, you know, I come across that maybe five generations ago, your ancestors actually had a child sacrifice. They actually made a deal with the devil and actually spilt blood. So you don't know that, right? You don't know what happened barely even two generations ago, let alone five. So that Moloch demon was passed down to that person. Okay, so how do you know that? Well, if you're barren, if you have female issues, like the time of the month is really hard on you, cervical cancer, uterine cancer, miscarriages is a big one. If you've had any miscarriages, that's usually a good sign. I've also seen Moloch team up with the demon of smoking. I'm not sure if maybe when the person was pregnant, they started smoking because they didn't care about the child. I don't know, but I've seen that twice now where Moloch teams up with a demon of smoking and actually are starting to burn out the lungs faster. You know, they're trying to kill the person. So those are the people who need to watch this. Now I need you to watch all the way through once so you can agree with me. Okay. I'm gonna do a prayer where I'm actually confronting your demons, okay, which is my standard prayer and deliverance. And so it's down in the description box, so you can look it over, read it over, so you can be in agreement with what I'm saying, what I'm asking, or what how I'm confronting the demons. I also encourage you, there's a canceling permission prayers. That would very much behoove you, highly encourage it, that you go through those prayers, you and the Holy Spirit, and you seek out legal rights that the demons have to you right now. I'm only going to focus on Moloch, guilt and shame, depression, and condemnation, because those usually are the ones that usually come in through the abortion. Okay, so first, before we get started, I have to raise your faith, okay, so this can work, so you can understand why this is going to work, and I'm just some talking head out here, okay? Principle number one is what I like to call the centurion principle, and that's found in Matthew 8, starting in verse 8. The centurion answered and said, Lord, I am not worthy that thou should come underneath my roof, but speak the word only, and my servant shall be healed. For I am a man under authority, having soldiers under me, and I say to this man, go, and he goeth, and to another, come, and he cometh. And to my servant, do this, and he doeth. When Jesus heard it, he marveled and said to them that followed, verily I say unto you, I have not found so great faith, no, not in Israel. So the centurion principle is distance does not matter. Okay, this is the principle we use where we do deliverances over Skype, or, you know, Omega Man does more of the phone, okay? So, centurion principle, distance does not matter. Principle number two, God is outside of time. Psalm 90, verse 4, for 1,000 years in thy sight are but as yesterday when it is past, and as a watch in the night. You know, other verses, a day is 1,000 years, 1,000 years is as a day, okay? So, doesn't matter if you watch this video 60 years from now, it still applies, all right? So God is outside of distance, and he's outside of time, okay? So he's watching right now, and he's also went before you. So he also knows if you're going to be in agreement with this video, if your heart is to get rid of Moloch, okay? All right, so principle 3 is very big, okay? That's the principle of agreement, all right? Amos 3:3, can two walk together except they be agreed? Matthew 18:19-20. Yeah, verily I say unto you, whatsoever ye shall bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatsoever ye shall loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. Again I say unto you, that if two of you shall agree on earth as touching anything that they shall ask, it shall be done for them of my Father which is in heaven. For where two or three are gathered together in my name, there am I in the midst of them. Okay, so even though I'm a talking head right now on a 2D screen, I'm still a child of God. I'm still the ambassador of Jesus Christ, and I'm agreeing with you, okay? So watch the video all the way through. If you agree with me, start it over, and then follow the prayers, okay? So I'll be leading you in prayers, and we'll try to be seeking the Holy Spirit together, okay? So first principle, centurion principle, distance doesn't matter. Time doesn't matter. Principle of agreement. Principle number 4 is that you're surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses, Hebrews 12:1. So God right now is watching. The holy angels are watching. You know, demons are watching. You know, it's doesn't matter that you watch this 60 years from now. You're still right now in your room or wherever you're at. God is watching you, okay? So, and the reason why he's watching you is because he's waiting for 2 Chronicles 7:14. If my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves, pray, seek my face, and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and will heal their land. Okay? So these are all the principles that we use in deliverance. So this is the reason why this video will work. It's not just some 2D talking head. You know, this will work. Okay? Okay, so those are the biblical principles to raise your faith so you can achieve, you know, the fruits of the Lord through this deliverance. So the reason why I shared the Bible with you is Romans 10. So then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Okay, so you heard the word of God. You understand, okay, the word of God says it. I believe it. Let's move on. All right. So some blockages, though, I do have to let you know, some blockages in deliverance is a spirit of confusion, and that usually comes through drug use, hypnotism, you know, Eastern meditation, New Age, opening up chakras, spirit guides. All that stuff is you're giving your mind over to a chemical substance or to a demon or to a guru or to meditation. You're giving your mind over, okay? And so anytime when I see somebody who has done drug use or any of those stuff, I automatically write down, okay, we have to deal with the confusion because then it's always there, okay? That's a defense mechanism that stops you from hearing God, stops you from, you know, the demons hide behind it. So it's a defense mechanism. So if you hear, like, you know, I'm asking you questions or I'm confronting the demon in you, and you keep on hearing yes, no, no, yes, that's usually a sign of confusion. All right, another demonic defense is doubt and unbelief. Without faith, you can't please God. So if there's a doubt and unbelief kingdom with you, it's going to be like, this guy's stupid. This guy doesn't know what he's talking about. This is a joke. I'm just making it up. This is just my own thoughts. This is stupid. Okay, that's doubt and unbelief. All right, that's another demonic defense mechanism that normally in a one-on-one session, we have to usually get rid of first, okay? Pride is another one. You know, God resists the proud. Deception. There's different things, okay? Sometimes demons threaten other demons. You know, the bigger demons threaten the smaller demons, saying, you better not talk, you know? You better shut up. You better not reveal me, okay? So there's a lot of different demonic defenses, okay? But for some of you, I know this is going to work because the Holy Spirit told me to do this, and the Holy Spirit doesn't tell his children to do worthless garbage, all right? So here's the principle. Most likely, so obviously I can't hear you what your answer is. So I'm going to go through like a normal deliverance session. I'm going to call forward Moloch. You're not channeling Moloch, okay? Moloch's already in you, all right? And Moloch normally also is already speaking to you. Another sign of Moloch is that I've seen is that you have an intense fear about your children's safety because Moloch is there for your kids. He wants to kill your kids, basically. He's a child sacrifice, bloodthirsty demon. All right, so, you know, if you can see a road and all you do is see your kids getting run over by a car, you see a roof and all you see your kids is falling down from the roof, or you see a tree and you see your kids breaking their neck from the tree, that's a usually sign of Moloch. He's tormenting you, all right? He does a wide variety of things, but I'm going to go through the prayer, okay? If you do not want to be delivered, And if you think this is all garbage, then you probably should stop the video, because this video will stir up most likely your demons, all right? My goal is not to stir them up. My goal is to confront them, okay? I am the ambassador of Jesus Christ. The demons, if you're a child of God, they are either trespassing, or if they have legal right, we need to find out what that legal right is. Take care of it by confessing, repenting, forgiving, and then cast them out, okay? So I'm going to read my prayers, and then be mindful of what's coming into your mind, okay? The mind is the battleground, all right? That's why the Bible says, take every thought captive unto the obedience of Jesus Christ. So the battle is in the mind, okay? So demons speak to your mind. That is how they tempt you. That is how they lie to you, condemn you, deceive you, okay? If you feel like, you know, you get thoughts like, I'm stupid, I can't amount to anything, I'll never finish. All those things are demonic. They're trying to, you know, or with abortion, you know, God's never going to forgive you. You'll never amount to anything. God, you know, you've gone too far. Those are all demonic lies, okay? So if you've heard that, you understand that demons talk to your mind, okay? So what this deliverance session is I, as the ambassador of Jesus Christ, is confronting the demon in you, and I'm commanding them to answer me, all right? And they're going to answer to your mind. So usually the first thing that pops into your mind is the right answer. And then the Holy Spirit will also confirm it with you. So the Holy Spirit wants you free more than you want yourself free, okay? It's his temple. You know, he wants his temple free. Don't try to blank out your mind. Don't try to do any mind games. Just listen, okay? And then I advise you, when I'm confronting the demons, don't pray, because it's hard to listen when you're praying, all right? Just relax, just breathe, and just listen, okay? And then you'll get the answer. Before we start, I do want to have you understand if your kids are under the age of accountability. Because if you've passed down Moloch to a kid under the age of accountability, then when you're getting delivered, your child can be getting delivered as well. So right now, repeat after me. Let's pray to the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, please reveal to me if my child, Matthew, Julie, Susan, is under the age of accountability. Yes or no? And so just listen, pause the video, do it for each kid. Holy Spirit, please reveal to me if my child, Susie, is under the age of accountability. Yes or no? Okay, you pause the video, you got your answers if your children are under the age of accountability. So now, when I'm casting the demon out, and when I ask the demon, confront the demon, are you in the child, you should get a yes or no, okay? Now if they're, you should now by the Holy Spirit, you have faith if they're under the age of accountability. Okay. So when I bind the kingdom as one inside you, before we cast it out, then, you know, I'll be commanding the demon, you know, is it true? Have you removed yourself from the children? Okay. So these are just something I'll be asking. All right. Okay. So I'm going to read my prayer. So even if you don't think you have demons, just listen to the prayer. See if it stirs up anything in you. And if it does, then that can answer your question if you're demonized or not. But I have seen people who do not experience any physical manifestations, but they're still demonized. Okay, so this isn't a catch-all, all right? So right now, I'm asking you, are you in agreement with me? Hopefully you've watched the video all the way through. Are you in agreement with me? Do you want to cast out Moloch, yes or no? Say it in front of God. Say it in front of God and his holy angels right now. Do you want to cast out Moloch? Are you in agreement with me? Okay. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, and as his ambassador, I now speak to all demons that have a demonic contract, intent, or plan against the viewer. I bind you hand, foot, and tail. I bind the strong man separately. You will not threaten, intimidate, or keep other demons from speaking or complying. All demons are now under the authority of the living, resurrected Lord Jesus, the one who defeated your master on the cross and who possesses the keys to death and hell. No demon will harm the viewer, nor leave the viewer and go to someone else. I command that all demons will not divide, fragment, or clone, nor use any form of demonic trickery or deception. If you have already divided, fragmented, or cloned, you are commanded to rejoin as one kingdom now. There will be no passing on of duties or calling on others to replace you. If there is a territorial spirit or demon outside of the viewer that has no legal right to the viewer, I command in the name of Jesus that you go back up now and do not return. All traffic will be one way, and that will be out and into the abyss. You will not return. I command that all demons destroy all intentions and contracts against the viewer, who I am in agreement with. All demonic works will cease. Damages, disorders, and diseases will be repaired and restored exactly as El Shaddai intended the viewer to be. Now, all demonic forces, whether hiding, sleeping, using shelves or dark corners, in the subconscious, coming and going, or floating in free circulation, you are now under the authority of Jesus Christ and His holy angels. You will be obedient, speak clearly, and speak the truth, or you will be tormented by the holy angels. All demonic leadership, principalities, powers, rulers of the darkness in this world and against spiritual wickedness in high places, you are bound in Jesus' name from scheming, planning, and from sending or lending any outside assistance or interference. To demons present, you are commanded to retrieve every seed that you have planted. You are commanded to uproot everything evil. Nothing will be left behind, including withdrawal effects. I now bind and break the assignments and shields of the confusion kingdom and the doubt and unbelief kingdom. I destroy all hiding places. You will obey me, the ambassador of Jesus Christ. I strip all demons of your weapons, armor, shields, and robes of authority. I loose all demon tongues, and I loose your abilities to feel, hear, and speak. When asked a question, you will speak loudly, clearly, and boldly. I only want to speak to the prince of each kingdom. To all straggler demons that do not have a kingdom, if you do not have a legal right to the viewer, I bind you to the weakest prince in the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I ask you to send your holy angels to assist me in warfare and to force the demons to obey me, the ambassador of Jesus Christ. If needed, please send an elite, powerful group of holy angels. I ask you, Father of Lights, to expose every dark corner and expose all evil deeds, lies, and strategies. To all demons that do not have a legal right to the viewer, right now, I cast you out into the abyss in the name of Jesus Christ, never to return. To the viewer, I loose you from all trespassing demons. Holy Spirit, this is your deliverance. The viewer is your temple. You know the strategy of the enemy and which demons we need to get rid of first. Okay, Holy Spirit, this is your show. Let's just cover our bases. Let's just cancel some rites right now, okay? So repeat after me. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I confess abortion as sin. Lord, forgive me for murder, for hatred, for not taking care of the gift of God that you gave me. Lord, please forgive me. Amen. If there's a condemnation spirit, I ask if you go downstairs, read those prayers. We'll try to find out what are the lies, okay, that you believe. Because condemnation, depression, those are all lies, okay? So let's cover some of our basis, all right? So repeat after me. In the name of Jesus Christ, I renounce the lie that I'm not worthy. I renounce the lie that I have gone too far and God cannot forgive me. I renounce the lie that I'm not good enough. I renounce the lie that I can never move forward. I'm always going to feel guilt and shame because of what I've done. That God will not accept me. That God doesn't love me. That I won't be a good mother. That I won't be a good father. Okay. So now I speak biblical truth over myself. Okay. Still repeat after me. So now I speak biblical truth over myself. Jesus Christ died for me. I am bought by the precious blood of Jesus Christ. So I am good enough. While I was in my mother's womb, the Lord Himself knitted me together. I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Nobody on earth can fulfill the destiny that God has given me. If Jesus Christ died while I was still a sinner, how much more so is He willing to give me all things now that I am His child? All right, so that's a huge principle that I just taught you right there. All right, so recognize the lie, renounce the lie out loud, and then speak biblical truth of yourself. If there's something that you always struggle with, go to the Word of God, try to find that specific Bible verse that directly goes to the heart of that lie, okay? Just like Jesus Christ, when He was rebuking the devil, He used the scripture right back at him, okay? Okay, so in the name of Jesus Christ, Moloch, I call you forward right now. Moloch, are you here, yes or no? Now again, to the viewer, you're just going to hear, you know, you can close your eyes, just stay in that zone. Don't pray, just listen, okay? I'm not going to feed you any answers. This isn't suggestibility. This isn't, you know, this isn't hypnotism. This is real. All right, I've been doing this for a while. This is how people get freed. I'm not there with you. I can't get instant feedback. So I just have to believe that God is going to do a special miracle. The holy angels are there. Holy angels, I ask that you help me out, that you, you know, torment these demons. You force them to speak. You bring them and you keep them to the surface. Do not allow them to dive into the darkness. Father of lights, please expose the darkness in the viewer right now. We just love you, Lord. Jesus Christ, thank you that you've already destroyed the demons, the works of the demons on the cross. The demons know that they're defeated. I know that they're defeated, okay? And the viewer, you need to know that they're defeated. Their power is in the lie. Their power is in darkness. So whatever pops in your mind, okay, then that's the answer what I want you to go with. And first, I'm going to go through the yes answer, then I'll go through the no answer, okay? So Moloch, in the name of Jesus Christ, are you here, yes or no? Okay, you said yes. Does that stand as truth before El Shaddai? All right, Moloch, do you have a legal right to the viewer right now? All right, you said yes. In the name of Jesus Christ, reveal your legal right to the viewer right now. Holy Spirit, we also ask you to make sure the demon speaks. Holy Spirit, reveal as well. Bring up a memory. Okay, if you've been revealed something in your mind, if something popped in your mind, and you can pause the video, maybe pray about it a little bit more. If you heard a yes, that he does have a legal right, then pray about it. Pause the video. Find out what that legal right is. Once you find out what that legal right is, you know, you haven't forgiven yourself. You don't forgive God. Whatever it is, just renounce it or ask for forgiveness, okay? And this is cool for your guilt and shame kingdom, okay? Because once you ask for forgiveness, once I bring back Moloch, I'm going to say, hey, now do you have a legal right? And most likely he'll say no, okay? So that is a huge thing because legal rights come from God, you know? You can't rebel against God and, you know, that's your free will. But if you open a door and a demon comes in, that legal right comes from God because we confess our sins to God and then that demon's legal rights are taken away right away. So it's miraculous. God hears you and God forgives you right away and takes the demon's legal rights, you know, within seconds. It's awesome. You know, I love this ministry. Okay. So I pray that you've found out if Moloch is there and if he has a legal right. If he says yes, you know, again, if the demon ain't saying anything, then repeat this. Holy Spirit, please reveal to me what the legal right is. And maybe some of you have a hard time hearing from the Holy Spirit, but understand, you know, the Holy Spirit and demons use your thoughts, okay? They speak to you in your thoughts, the whisper. It's just you can decipher which is which by what they're saying. You know, is one leading me to death and one leading me to life? Is one causing guilt and shame and condemnation and one is causing conviction and allowing me to move forward in joy and peace, okay? Huge difference. All right, so Moloch, in Jesus Christ, come back up. Do you now have a legal right to the viewer? Yes or no? Okay, you said no. Does that stand as truth before El Shaddai? Okay. Moloch, are you doing any physical damage to the viewer? Are you damaging the body physically? Yes or no? Moloch, in the name of Jesus Christ, reveal to the viewer, what are you doing to the body? All right. So Moloch, based on your own admission, you are a trespasser. You have no legal rights any longer to the viewer. So I command in the name of Jesus Christ that you fix your damage all the way up on what El Shaddai intended the viewer to be. Holy angels, I ask that you supervise and you monitor, make sure Moloch cleans up all of his damage. Moloch, in the name of Jesus Christ, are you in the child that is under the age of accountability? And right now, you know, you're in agreement with me. You know, this is your demon, you know, so you're in agreement with me, okay? You can also say, okay, you know, pause it. Moloch, are you in my child Susan? Are you also in my child Billy, okay? You can add those specifics. So in the name of Jesus Christ, Moloch, reveal to the viewer, are you in the children under the age of accountability, yes or no? All right. Someone assume he says yes. Moloch, in the name of Jesus Christ, have you followed the command? Have you fixed your damage? And I command you fix your damage in the children as well. So Moloch, in the name of Jesus Christ, based on your own admission, you're a trespasser. This viewer has been bought already by the most precious blood of Jesus Christ. So this viewer is not yours. Okay, you are now trespassing. So have you followed that command? Have you cleaned up your mess in the viewer and also in the children? Yes or no? Okay, you said yes. Does that stand as truth before El Shaddai? All right, Moloch, I bind your kingdom as one in the viewer right now. I command that you withdraw yourself from the children, and I bind your kingdom as one in the viewer. In the name of Jesus Christ, Moloch, have you followed that command? Have you removed all of yourself from the children? Yes or no? Okay, you said yes. Does that stand as truth before El Shaddai? Okay, hopefully you heard a yes. Now, any of this, if these answers aren't going, you know, the way that they need to be going, then, you know, you can pause the video, get the Holy Spirit involved, get the Lord involved. You yourself, you know, in the name of Jesus Christ, you need to obey the man of God, holy angels. You yourself can say, holy angels, I've heard this Moloch demon said that he does not have a legal right to me. So he's not obeying the man of God. So therefore, holy angels, I loose you to torment this trespassing demon. Okay, these are rules, guys. There are spiritual rules that these demons and angels abide by, okay? Jesus Christ paid for you. Do you understand? The moment you accepted Jesus Christ, you are not your own. You gave your life to God. He bought you with his blood. Amen? So if these demons have their legal rights taken away from them, they cannot stay. They're trespassing. Understand? So if they're trespassing, it's legal for the holy angels to torment them until they're gone. You understand? So there's rules. So, you know, if you have to pause and seek the Holy Spirit, if any answer is not going the way it needs to be, then, or even write me, okay? Hey, I was at this point, you know, I got this, you know, write me, whatever, okay? Or if you feel like you need even deeper deliverance, then that's what I'm here for. So Moloch, in name of Jesus Christ, you have removed yourself from the children. You have cleaned up your mess all the way up into what El Shaddai intended that person to be. You have righted the womb. You have righted your damage. So in name of Jesus Christ, I sever you from the territorial spirit of Moloch. I sever you from the territorial spirit Moloch. And now I'm speaking to the worker Moloch inside of the viewer. I bind your kingdom as one. I strip you of your robes, your shields, your weapon, and your armor. And I cast you into the abyss now, never to return. Based on your own admission, you're a trespasser. I cast you into the abyss now, never to return. So right now, as a sign of agreement with me, just exhale. Because spirit means pneuma, which in the Greek, which means air, where we get the word pneumatic, okay? So just exhale. The demon can go out another way. It doesn't have to come by the breath. But you're just, as a sign of agreement with me, exhale. Repeat after me. In the name of Jesus, I cast you out, Moloch, into the abyss, never to return. Amen? So if you felt a release, you feel lighter, you may not feel any physical manifestations at all, but you'll see the fruit. You know, another thing I've seen Moloch do a couple times now is that after childbirth, you'll have long-lasting lower back pain. That's another thing Moloch does. So if your lower back is now freed, you know, sometimes it takes the body a little bit to heal itself once the demons are gone. So here's a huge principle about deliverance as well. Some of you are able to achieve great levels of deliverance, you know, on the first session, and it just goes really smoothly because your knowledge of the Word of God and the truths have been expounded, and you're actually a strong Christian, but you've just never been delivered. Now, that goes back to Exodus 23, 29, 30. So with the Israelites, our example is when they went into the Promised Land, and then they were driving out the enemy from the Promised Land, right? Jericho, they had to go around it, praise, worship. That's one way you get rid of some demons. Other demons is God directly goes in front of you. Other demons we have to directly assault, okay? So Exodus 23, here's a very important verse about deliverance, okay? Starting in verse 29, God is talking to Israel, and he says, I will not drive them out, your enemies, out before you in 1 year. lest the land become desolate and the beasts of the field multiply against thee. Verse 30, by little and little I will drive them out before thee until thou be increased and inherit the land. Okay, so, you know, if you know the spiritual truths and you understand God is good and you know, you don't have grudges against him and all this stuff, you have a good relationship with God, you're able to inherit a lot of the land. Does that make sense? And so some of your deliverances with a lot of people, really easy. You know, they get delivered all in one, you know, within a couple hours. You know, other people that have really weak relationships with God, they don't know the truth. They blame God for everything. They're angry at God. They don't forgive. They don't repent. You know, those people, they haven't inherited much of the land. And so God won't deliver them of very much. Does that make sense? So some of you out there, you know, you've inherited this land, especially about Moloch and the abortion and stuff like that, and you're ready. So that's the reason why the Holy Spirit has me do this. Maybe this video isn't for some, and they just need more deeper one-on-one deliverance. Okay, so we got rid of Moloch, all right? So we're going to go after, let's see. So let's go after depression. So in the name of Jesus Christ, I call forward the highest ranking prince over depression. Come forward now. In the name of Jesus Christ, the highest ranking prince of depression, are you here? Yes or no? Demon of depression, do you have a legal right to the viewer? Yes or no? All right. You said yes. Does that stand as truth before El Shaddai? Okay. In the name of Jesus Christ, the highest ranking prince over depression, what is your legal right to the viewer? Speak clearly. In the name of Jesus Christ, I command you, speak clearly. What is your legal right? Or let me ask another way. Demon of depression, in the name of Jesus Christ, what is the lie that you told the viewer that they believe? All right. In the name of Jesus Christ, is there any other lies? What else? All right, so if you got a lie, then you just say, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I renounce the lie that da-da-da-da-da. I renounce the lie, da-da-da-da-da. In the name of Jesus Christ, I confess and believe in that lie as sin. I ask you, forgive me. I speak biblical truth over myself, and this is where your homework comes in. You have to find out what the biblical truth is. You know, the joy of the Lord will be my strength. Whatever combats that lie that has caused the depression. I'm not good enough. You know, I never amount to anything. Whatever the depression is, you have to renounce the lie, then speak biblical truth over it, okay, over yourself, all right? All right, so pause the video, do that, all right? So name Jesus Christ, highest ranking prince, come forward now. Name Jesus Christ, do you now have a legal right to the viewer, yes or no? You said no. Will that answer stand on judgment day as truth? All right, demon of depression, are you in the children under the age of accountability? Yes or no? All right. I'll just assume that he says yes to cover our basis. Demon of depression, in the name of Jesus Christ, are you doing any physical damage to the viewer? Yes or no? You said yes. In the name of Jesus Christ, what is the physical damage that you are doing to the viewer? Demon of depression, in the name of Jesus Christ, based on your own admission, you're a trespasser. You said you have no legal right anymore. I command that you fix your damage to the viewer. I command that you fix your damage to the child under the age of accountability, and you do it now. Holy angels, supervise this demon. Make sure they do their fix the damage. In the name of Jesus Christ, highest ranking prince over depression, have you followed that command? Have you fixed your damage in the viewer and in the child under the age of accountability? Yes or no? You said yes. Does that stand as truth before El Shaddai? Demon depression, I bind your kingdom of depression as one in the viewer. I command that you remove yourself completely from the child of the age, under the age of accountability. Remove yourself now. Demon of depression, have you followed that command? Have you removed yourself from the child? Yes or no? Okay, you said yes. Does that stand as truth before El Shaddai? Demon of depression, name Jesus Christ based on your own admission. You have already confessed that you're a trespasser. I bind your kingdom of depression. I strip you of your robes, your shields, your weapon, and your armor, and I cast you into the abyss, never to return. Leave now. Go ahead and exhale as a sign of agreement. Repeat after me. In the name of Jesus, I cast you, highest ranking prince of depression and the kingdom of depression, into the abyss, never to return. I'm in agreement. Okay. Hopefully you're getting some physical manifestations. You know, if you know, especially if Moloch, if he's doing something to your lower back and all that stuff, you know, hopefully that pain is gone now. That is a sign to build your faith. Okay. Highest ranking prince over condemnation. And you can pause the video anytime, take a bathroom break, you know, go to the restroom, you know, get some water. You know, this is pretty laid back. Okay. And this is usually how the deliverance sessions go. It's very peaceful. It's very laid back. You know, a lot of compassion from the Lord that I feel towards the viewer. There's a lot of things that it's pretty neat. In the name of Jesus Christ, the highest ranking prince over condemnation, come forward now. In the name of Jesus Christ, condemnation, are you here? Yes or no? You said yes. Does that stand as truth before El Shaddai? Demon of condemnation, do you have a legal right to the viewer? Yes or no? You said yes. Does that stand as truth before El Shaddai? Demon of condemnation, what is the lie that you tell the viewer that they believe? Speak clearly. In the name of Jesus Christ, what is the lie that you tell the viewer that they believe? And holy angels, I loose you if any demon is not speaking to the viewer. I loose you on these demons to force them to speak, to reveal their legal rights, to speak the truth. Holy angels, I trust you. God, I know you went before me already. You're already there taking care of it, even if they're watching this video 60 years from now. Demon of condemnation, in the name of Jesus Christ, any other lies? What else? What else? What other lie does the viewer believe? Okay, so again, in the name of Jesus Christ, I renounce the lie that I'm not good enough. I renounce the lie, whatever the lie is, okay? I confess of believing these lies as sin and not believing the truth, not believing the word of God. Lord, please forgive me. I speak biblical truth over myself now, okay? I am good enough. You know, use the word of God, okay? Find, do your research, BibleGateway.com. It's hard for me to tell you the biblical truth to combat it if I don't know what the specific lie is, all right? So once you prayed the prayers, you spoke biblical truth over yourself, you confessed this sin. Demon of condemnation, in the name of Jesus Christ, come back forward now. Do you now have a legal right to the client? Yes or no? You said no. Does that stand as truth before El Shaddai? So if you still got, yes, I still have a legal right, and yes, you know that does stand as truth before El Shaddai, then most likely you're going to have to pause the video. You know, command the demon, name Jesus Christ. Okay, what is the other lie that you believe? If you don't hear anything, go to the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, please reveal to me what is the legal right this demon has to me. Okay, so we confront the demon first. If they're not talkative, then just go to the Holy Spirit. If you feel comfortable just going straight to the Holy Spirit, that's fine. But, you know, I do this for a reason. You know, demons, when they're confronted by the power and the blood of the authority of Jesus Christ, they will speak. Demon of condemnation, in the name of Jesus Christ, based on your own admission, you're a trespasser. Are you doing any physical damage to the viewer? Yes or no? You said yes. Does that stand as truth before El Shaddai? Demon of condemnation, how physically are you damaging the viewer, the viewer's body? Demon of condemnation, highest ranking prince over condemnation, are you in the children under the age of accountability? Yes or no? You said yes. Does that stand as truth before El Shaddai? Deem of condemnation based on your own admission. You are a trespasser. I command that you fix your damage to the viewer and to the child under the age of accountability. Fix them now. Fix your mess. Demon of condemnation, have you followed that command? Have you fixed your mess? Have you fixed your mess? Yes or no? You said yes. Does that stand as truth before El Shaddai? Demon of condemnation, I bind your kingdom as one. I command that you remove yourself from the children under the age of accountability. I bind your kingdom as one inside the viewer. Have you followed that command? Have you removed yourself completely from the children under the age of accountability? Yes or no? Demon of condemnation based on your own admission, you're a trespasser. I strip you of your robes, your shield, your weapons, and your armor, and I cast you into the abyss, never to return. Leave now in the name of Jesus Christ. Exhale, sign of agreement. In the name of Jesus, I cast you, kingdom of condemnation, into the abyss, never to return. So again, this stuff is pretty simple. If they have legal right, that is legal right that God has given them. Okay? God uses demons as discipline. God uses, you know, if you're going to rebel against God, he's going to not make life enjoyable for you. He wants you to come back. He wants you to come back to the fold. Okay? Little sheep, if they keep on scurrying outside of the fold, you know, they're going to fall to the wolves. They're going to fall to the lion. They're going to fall into a pit. So the shepherd breaks the back of their legs, carries them in his hip pocket. And so there's this bond that is created between him and the lamb. And so when the lamb's legs heal and mend, that lamb stays right by his side. Okay? Because in the macro scale, in the macro level, God does not want you to go to hell. God does not want you to be deceived. God does not want you to be wolf food or fall into a pit. Okay? Amen? It's love. You discipline your child. You love your child. Same thing. So now you've committed sin. You've opened the doors. Maybe even generational curses have come in. And that's another thing too. If the Holy Spirit reveals to you that you have these demons have legal rights based on the generational curse, you break the generational curse by saying, you know, Lord, I accept full responsibility for the sins of my ancestors. You know, you're a royal priesthood. You know, Lord, please forgive us for the child sacrifice. Lord, please forgive us for believing that, you know, this lie. You know, ask the demon, you know, what happened four generations ago? You've been here four generations ago? Okay, what happened four generations ago that allowed you to come into my lineage? You know, ask the Holy Spirit. You may get something that comes to mind, you know? And you really have to trust that the Holy Spirit is in control right now, okay? Whatever pops into your mind, you have to believe that the Lord is directing you in that direction for a reason, okay? If all of a sudden it's like, man, I have, you know, I just thought about this album, this satanic album that I have that I totally forgot about, or this t-shirt that I got from some strip club or whatever happened, you know, your mind goes to those things for a reason. The Holy Spirit's saying, hey, I need you to take care of this. Destroy this item. This is an open door for the enemy to come into your household or into your family. This is what's causing disease in your home. You know, you really got to be aware, not only is the battle, the mind is the battleground, but this is the way, you know, you also have the mind of Christ. You know, this is the way that God speaks to us. And yes, he speaks to us through the word of God, but, you know, he also speaks to us directly. Okay, one last kingdom, and then, I believe the assignment from the Holy Spirit is fulfilled. So, in the name of Jesus Christ, the highest ranking prince over the guilt and shame kingdom, come forward now. In the name of Jesus Christ, the highest ranking prince over guilt and shame, come forward now. Guilt and shame, are you here? Yes or no? Demon of guilt and shame, the highest ranking prince, do you have a legal right to the viewer? Yes or no? You said yes. Does that stand as truth before El Shaddai? Demon of guilt and shame, what is your legal right to the viewer? And guilt and shame could be, you don't forgive yourself, you don't forgive God, you blame God. Guilt and shame could be unforgiveness as well. But usually it's a lie again. So name Jesus Christ, highest ranking prince over guilt and shame. What is the lie that you've told the viewer that they believe? Demon of guilt and shame, is there any other lies? What else? Okay, so again, renounce the lies, speak biblical truth over yourself, pause the video. In the name of Jesus Christ, guilt and shame, I call you forward. Do you now have a legal right to the viewer, yes or no? You said no. Does that stand as truth before El Shaddai? Demon of guilt and shame, are you doing anything physically to the body? Are you damaging the body physically? You said yes. In the name of Jesus Christ, does that stand as truth before El Shaddai? Okay, what are you doing to the body physically? Demon of guilt and shame, are you also in the children that are under the age of accountability, yes or no? You said yes. Will that answer stand as truth on Judgment Day? Demon of guilt and shame, I command that you fix your damage. Whatever mess you're causing to the physical body, I command you fix your damage now in the name of Jesus Christ. And also, if you're doing any physical damage to children, fix your damage now. Holy angels, monitor, supervise. Make sure they withdraw every demonic seed, every ailment, whatever they're messing with. Demon of guilt and shame, have you followed that command? Have you fixed your damage in the name of Jesus Christ? Yes or no? You said yes. Does that stand as truth before El Shaddai? And if the demon says no, you know, I have not fixed my damage, you know, then pause the video, command the demon, okay, do you have legal right? And you're just relying. You know, what is that legal right? Sometimes they're just stubborn. And if they're stubborn and they say, no, I don't have a legal right, then say, okay, based on your own admission, you're a trespasser. I've been bought with the blood of Jesus Christ. I am not yours. So you're trespassing. You admit that you're trespassing. So holy angels, I loose the holy angels that are surrounding me right now to torment this demon because it's going against the spiritual rules that God has set up. Okay? Okay, so in the name of Jesus Christ, I bind the demon of guilt and shame as one in the viewer. I command that you remove yourself completely from the children under the age of accountability. Do that now. So in the name of Jesus Christ, demon of guilt and shame, have you followed that command? Have you removed yourself completely from the children? Yes or no? Does that stand as truth before El Shaddai? Demon, guilt, and shame, based on your own admission, you're a trespasser. I bind your kingdom as one. I strip you of your robes, your shields, your weapon, and your armor, and I cast you into the pit of hell, never to return. Leave now. Exhale. Repeat after me. In the name of Jesus Christ, kingdom of guilt and shame, I command you into the abyss, never to return. Leave now. So you've been in agreement with me. If this is the first time you're watching the video, go back, watch it again, and then actually follow through with the prayers, okay? Sometimes it's just get a quiet place, no distractions. You know, if you're not sure about this whole thing, just pray before it. Lord, I want whatever is holy. I reject anything that's unholy. I pray that you protect me. Ask the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, is this legit? You know? Truth doesn't mind investigation, okay? If you have felt physical manifestations, if you haven't felt them leave, I'm going to post Stay Free down below, okay? Please read it, okay? It's very important. Basically, if you have felt the demons leave and... Okay, so let's confirm it. Repeat after me. Holy Spirit, please confirm to me that Moloch has left me. Just let me know. Give me a peace. Lord, please let me know. Okay. So if you felt a peace or you heard clean or if you heard, okay, you're good to go, then that is your faith where you plant your flag of faith. Plant your flag of faith that the Holy Spirit confirmed in you, okay? So when the demons come back, you know, when Moloch says, hey, you know, you know, let's say you had lower back. And so he activates the lower back pain. He says, look, I never left. You know, no, you can say the Holy Spirit confirmed in me. And do this with the guilt and shame, the condemnation, the depression. Do that with those kingdoms as well, okay? again, this is kind of new for me. I usually get instant feedback. I know exactly what the demons are saying. You know, I usually ask the demons more questions. You know, how many demons are in your kingdom? You know, that's usually how we get a number of how many demons a person had. You know, demon of guilt and shame, how many demons were in your kingdom? You know, 20. Does that stand as truth before El Shaddai? Yes. Okay. So if the Holy Spirit confirms with you that you're freed of these four different kingdoms, then if the lower back comes back, you can say, no, I rebuke you. In the name of Jesus Christ, you were cast out. The door was shut. And understand, too, the door is shut. We don't cast out demons unless they say I have no legal right. When they say they have no legal right, that means the door is shut. It doesn't mean that they come back in, okay? You have to, again, open the door to that, which I assume you're not going to have another abortion. Please. So if you have an anointing oil or olive oil, I ask you, you know, pause the video. Please go get it. You know, put it on your forehead. It's just a sign of consecration, okay? Holy oil, it's very biblical. James, you know, even back in the Old Testament, they anointed the temple and the items of the temple, okay? They set it apart. They consecrated those items. So let's pray for healing, okay? So in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, we thank you for what you've done. Jesus Christ, thank you for dying on the cross for our sins. We know that you have destroyed the works of the devil. And if it wasn't because of your sacrifice and what you did on the cross, in Isaiah 53:5, by your stripes you were healed. So when you're being whipped, you actually took our diseases and sicknesses on the cross. Lord, we thank you. We praise your name, your most holy name. Thank you for what you've done. Father of light, thank you for going before us. Thank you for setting us up. Thank you for sending the holy angels before they even watched this video, before they even knew they're going to watch the video. You already set this up. You preordained it, Lord. So I thank you for your power, your love, your mercy, and your grace. Right now, I speak healing in the name of Jesus Christ to the womb. I command that you come into alignment with the word of God. Jesus Christ took that barrenness on the cross, and I speak to that womb. And I speak life in the name of Jesus Christ. Be healed in the name of Jesus Christ. Bring forth life now. If you have issues with your female issues, I command that they come into alignment. In the name of Jesus Christ, I loose your back pain. All demons that are messing with that have come through depression, condemnation, guilt, shame, Moloch, I loose you, viewer, in the name of Jesus Christ. No more torment. I speak to the body. I speak life. Come into alignment with the word of God now in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we thank you that we have consecrated this person. You know, bring them back into a unity, a more truth, Lord. Show them, reveal unto them the truth. Take away more and more veils. Lord, we just love you. Father, thank you for sending your son. Jesus, thank you for accepting the assignment to die on the cross. We love you. We praise your name. And if it wasn't for you, this wouldn't be possible. So let me know what happened. If you have any questions, if there's any glitch and, you know, maybe you heard this or this. Like I said, if you're getting yes, no, no, yes answers, then that's usually a sign of confusion, okay? So, yeah, so, you know, I do one-on-ones, so that just may be a sign that you maybe need more deliverance, okay? Like I said, Moloch is so prevalent, that I can't get to, you know, all the deliverance ministers in the world can't get to everybody who has Moloch, I guarantee it. So pass this out if it blessed you. Pass the video out to anybody else that you believe may have had an abortion or is affected by this, is barren, has intense cramping, all that stuff during the menstrual cycle, all that stuff, miscarriages, all that stuff is usually a sign, okay? If you have an owl in your house, get rid of it, destroy it, okay? I don't care what it is. I don't care if it's a grandmother's $2 million brooch, okay? You need to destroy that stuff. That is a creature of the night, okay? And our country worships it. Seriously, go to any store right now. It's on every single clothing. It's on every single pot, planter, couch, curtains. I mean, Satan is having a heyday. This country is having a heyday in worshiping Moloch. It's disgusting, okay? Just if you have eyes to see, you can see this worship. You know what? Why is everything an owl, a frog, a reptile? It's just sick, you know? Like, why have all these creatures of the night? Or, you know, why is that trendy? Who, you know? Okay, so I love you guys. I'm going to be strict with the comments down below because this is a sensitive subject. If you have legit questions, you know, I'll post it. If you have praise reports, you know, please, 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 testimony. By the word of the testimony, you overcome the enemy, okay? Your testimonies are huge. So, you know, Let the dust settle. Please go down to the Stay Free worksheet. Please read it now so you know what to expect when the demons say they try to come back and try to tempt you and try to say, hey, we never left. You know, they're liars. They're liars. You have to stand your ground. The ground that we fought for, stay with it, okay? Don't give it back to the enemy. Oh, yeah, I guess the deliverance was a joke. Okay, no, don't do that. The Holy Spirit confirmed in you, okay? I love you. I really have a heart for you guys. I do not like this demon, okay? We come across it a lot. All right, love you. God bless.